You asked to see me?
You're the senior consultant?
Yes, but Mr. Byrne is in charge of your case.
That's why I asked to see you. I collapsed. It was an emergency operation.
Mr. Byrne carried out a successful procedure. You're making a good recovery.
But why did it get to that point? Why wasn't I operated on sooner?
As I understand it, medication was thought an option.
Yeah, but that was the wrong choice, wasn't it? I told Mr. Byrne, you know best, whatever you decide.
Not the wrong choice, a perfectly rational one. Not least because you were eager to get back to work.
Yeah, but not at any cost. I almost died in there. Something went wrong, a cannula or whatever. If it hadn't been for Dr. Griffin, I could have been going out of here in a box. I was given bad advice. That's why I collapsed.
Mrs. Collins, medicine is very rarely a precise science. We tried to do our best. We did our best for you, and fortunately, our best was good enough. Of course, you can make a complaint if you feel that's the right thing to do.
No. No need for that. It was my fault, a lot of it. I kept nagging on about wanting to get back to the shop. I was pushing it. I should have put my health first. I will in future.
Very sensible. The operation went well. Just slow down a bit. Take time to recover. Mrs. Griffin? How did Mrs. Collins know about the difficulty with the venous cannula?
Well, she asked about the procedure. I couldn't lie.
It was very clever of you to solve the problem at the time. It was a long way from clever to worry her about something that was easily resolved.
Well, I mentioned the cannula without thinking. It was a mistake.
Quite right. It was.
Well, actually, she did ask to see Mr. Byrne.
And where was he? Just, you know, think before you speak next time. Could you page Mr. Byrne for me? Tell him I want a word.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yes, I have seen this before. It was confidential when it was sent, and it still is confidential, or should be.
It was an accident. I was going through Matron's paperwork. Anyway, that's not the point. This is a totally wrong-headed idea. Matron thinks so, and so do I.
Well, let me just make it clear. This email was a response to my ordering a feasibility study. My matron was just looking at ways of cutting costs.
It was me. My suggestion. It was the result of a hurried assessment made on my first day here. It was a mistake. I'm so sorry.
It was you.
We talked about this. I told you I thought I'd made a mistake. I thought that was the end of it.
Well, I thought it through and decided it was a matter for the board. I'm really sorry you found out this way.
It's gone to the board?
It's on the agenda, yes.
But she's just told you it was a mistake. You're the CEO. Do something about it.
Chrissie, leave it.
Vanessa, I've made a grave error. Now I've spent time on AAU, it's clear that consultant nurse Williams is vital to the running of the ward. I mean, beyond his skill and experience, he plays an essential part in pre-op assessments. If that were compromised, you'd be in severe danger of missing your 18-week targets. In fact, I don't see how you'd meet them.
And this hadn't occurred to you before?
More to you.
Well, she's right. Surely you can see that.
I was taking my lead from Matron's report. Now, if she still feels that she's made a mistake, then we will look at it again. But now, if you'll excuse me, I have a meeting.
So it was you all along. Why didn't you say so?
Chrissie.
Two-faced or what? And all the time, you made me believe that you were on our side.
I am on your side. Didn't you hear me say that? Look, I was wrong. I was hasty. I apologise. Mark, they asked for an early assessment. I knew they were looking for cutbacks, and it was my first day, and I wanted to impress. I just didn't take time to think things through.
Two people on the ward, possibly one too many.
It looked like that at first. It was a mistake. I'm so sorry.
Can you believe she did that?
No.
What do you mean, one too many? You're not going to forgive her.
Chrissie.
Well, I'm certainly not.
And they're sending me on a training course. But it's just for a week.
When?
I don't know. They haven't told me yet, but soon, I think.
Okay, well, let me know so I can call you. Okay.
Maybe it's best if I call you.
Yeah. Done in.
Yeah, I'll go.
I'm sorry. I love you.
He's sleeping a lot, isn't he?
Yeah, that's normal.
Normal?
Well, for his condition, I mean.
He's in a bad way, isn't he?
Well, he's a priority patient. He needs a transplant.
What are his chances?
Of getting a heart?
Well, yeah, that and, you know, or surviving. God, I expect that must sound awful.
No, it's a perfectly reasonable question. It's what anyone in your position would want to know. Look. Heart transplants are very common these days. I mean, the success rate is high. It's close to 95%.
After it's done, he's going to need some looking after, isn't he?
Yeah, he's going to need care at first. The practical kind, the tender and loving kind. But there'll be support groups he can go to and people who've been through the same thing. Most of them are leading perfectly normal lives.
So, now you've had the tour, you still want to give it a go?
I've already said yes means yes.
Sorry.
It'll be all right. I'm really looking forward to it.
Good. Look, do me a favour. Keep your grandparents in the loop. Let them know what you're up to. You're a big part of life.
I know.
Yeah, after your mother.
Look, Dad, I know they love me. I know that.
I'm going to check my emails. See you on.
Sure. Dad, is there any way out of that bedpan thing?
No. She's on your staff, Joseph.
How could I have known she was going to give Mrs. Collins a blow-by-blow account?
Yes. Yes, come in. Mrs. Collins isn't going to bring an official complaint, but she easily could have.
It seemed reasonable to try medication as a first option. Maybe go to elective surgery in a month or so if all went well.
She didn't have a month or so.
She stopped taking her prescribed medication, which made a prognosis more difficult.
Yes, difficult.
But surgery was the better option. Why choose medication?
It was raised as a possible course of action. But in the end, of course, it was Mr. Byrne's decision.
Oh, you're quite right, of course. It's my decision, my responsibility.
Last one.
And 15 minutes over your deadline.
It was quite a lot to get through.
Really, I thought you said you could cope.
He would have if it hadn't been for Mr. Flowers.
Where is he?
It wasn't cellulitis.
I noticed that it was spreading, getting darker. The patient was deteriorating. Mr. Spence had a look. It was synergistic gangrene. I scrubbed in for the operation, which is why...
And the patient?
Oh, he's fine. He's in the recovery room.
Synergistic gangrene?
Apparently, it's indistinguishable from cellulitis in the early stages.
Yeah, that's right, it is. Update soon, okay?
Williams. I've given some thought to what Matron said, and my conclusion is she's right.
So I keep me job?
Yes.
To help with targets?
Not just that, no. Matron made a suggestion and I was obliged to take it seriously.
You were going to put it to the board.
It was going forward as one possibility amongst many. I doubt if it would have ever have gained the board's approval. It certainly wouldn't have got my vote. No, you're a valued member of staff, Mark. The hospital needs you.
Mrs. Ellis, have you made a decision?
Did you look at the scan?
I did, yes.
I'm going to counsel her against surgery. It's too big a risk. Even if she doesn't die, an operation could leave her seriously debilitated. With careful medication, she could have a good year. Spend it with her family. Set her affairs in order.
Good. Yes, that's what I would have done.
Close call. Let's see why Dr. Valentine was confused. So
I am cruel. Chrissie. If I had you.
She'll get off my case now.
I wouldn't count on it.
Daisha, thanks.
I'm still sorry.
It's okay.
Wait for Saturday till Strictly. I have good news. You don't have to. Feed your need for all things Strictly by going online throughout the week for all kinds of exclusives. bbc.co.uk/strictly.
Facing a hurricane en route, Shane Ritchie and Josie Lawrence are on the last leg around the world in 80 days. Next on BBC One.